Welcome back, everybody, here to your broadcast of the Gigabyte Challenge. I'm your host for the English live stream, Toby Juanes. We're here at grand final time to do the Balkan Bears going up against Hellraisers in what I will hope be an entertaining game like the other one, which is going on currently. But I'm hoping this will be just as good. I don't know if we could really hit that mark, but we'll give it a crack. Hellraisers going up against the Balkan Bears. Joining me for tonight's broadcast, it is Dokodona. Welcome back. Welcome back, man.
Yeah, my jaw is on the floor right now. I'm watching the other game. I didn't even realize this game had started. Just watching it go back and forth, and no one really wants to actually do anything.
I looked at it. I'm like, the ticket's a little bit late, isn't it? Maybe this should be a game, which is like updated by now. No. It's actually that long. Yeah. But anyway, let's focus on our little corner of the world. So, Hellraisers versus the Balkan Bears. Hellraisers, after playing what could only be described as a mind-effed game in their semi-finals. Balkan Bears is a little bit more convincing from them. So, right now, I'm still favoring Hellraisers in the grand final, but the Balkan Bears will definitely fight, and they'll fight hard.
I think the Balkan Bears definitely have the skill advantage over Hellraisers, but Hellraisers seem to know how each other plays. They've got pretty good synergy between the players, and their drafting seems quite a bit stronger. We'll have to see if BBC brings something interesting to the party, and they're picking up Phoenix again. We saw 4ASC pick that hero up, and it didn't work too well in the hands of Jirax. They played it as a support. There were some pretty nice moves here and there. You know, you had the tornado into the egg combo, where you could lift people up in the air and try and get it to land. But Phoenix, to me, I just feel like he needs to be in a core role. I know you've mentioned you've seen him as a support work well a couple of times. I just feel like he needs levels. He needs to get that level 2 in a supernova.
I just keep looking at supernova as a, wow, it really looks like it's an interesting ability, but I never really feel the full effect of it. Never fully. Not in team fights, at least.
He needs something really big like a black hole or RP from Magnus, Tidehunter Ravage. He needs that initial setup where he swoops in, gets the debuff onto people, gets the Icarus dive into the middle of a couple of them, uses his ultimate, and then his teammate uses RP or Magnus ultimate just to give him enough time for it to land.
That's a pretty tall ask, though.
Yeah, it is one of those skills that requires so much teamfight coordination that it's difficult to pull off. It seems nice in theory, but if you don't have that massive amount of coordination in teamfights, then
it's not just teamfight, but it's also the ability to catch people out in a position like that. Most teams shouldn't find themselves in such a position, and if you are, then you kind of blame yourself. I just don't see the Phoenix like controlling you enough to really force you into that. And it's very obvious when he starts it. It's like, oh, I'm doing this so then people can then come in behind me. So, yeah. I'm just not a massive fan of the hero. I hate the hero in general.
I'm not a massive fan. I hate it. It's awful.
I realize how powerful it is in lane, and that just frustrates me more than anything else. Like, oh, great. I got fire on me, and for some reason I can't attack quickly while I have fire on me. I thought I'd move faster if I'm on fire.
It's like, oh, you want those last hits, huh? You want to harass me, huh? Well, you can't touch me.
Hellraisers pick up. This is perfect for them. Ogre Magi, you see it again. You'll see it every game if they let them have it. Easy stunners, easy controllers. But what makes it really Hellraisers pick up is the Disruptor. It's always turned one kill into two kills. Have a good team fight controller, but it's just more importantly just that control, the ability just to keep going and keep fighting. Like, that's where Hellraisers get their power from. They like to roll with the punches.
Yeah, it's such a good hero up against Phoenix as well. That Icarus dive is so great for him to go high up into a lane, get some last hits and harass onto the one roll hero, and then escape. Not be under any threat from the supports. But when you've got Glimpse on your side, there's no chance for Phoenix to actually play as aggressively as he'd like.
5 seconds remaining.
And then Ogre Magi setting him on fire once again with the Ignite.
5 seconds remaining.
And Meepo Band. Poor Weeha.
Such a shame for him. Such a shame.
Radiant team ban.
Anyway, Animage, Zeus, PA all being added to the ban pool. So looking at the big cores. And also just again that Zeus, the nuker. The very favored nuker of late. But then they get Legion Commander. So the Balkan Bears, they get the manliest woman of them all. to see if she can find that higher level of control. Problem is, what are you going to do? You're going to blink in, start a duel up. If it's not on the disruptor, you get glimpsed back. If it's on the Ogre Magi, you get stunned. How effective is this hero really meant to be?
Yeah, and where do they run her? Because we've seen Legion mid a couple of times. Most of the time we see her off lane. I think once or twice I've seen a one roll Legion. It's a really unusual best position for her is off lane. Because she can do really well against safe lane, tri lane, spamming out the overwhelming odds. And you can get a massive amount of damage onto the creep wave. Radiant team pick. So you've always got this potential to get farm and experience regardless of who you're against. Oh dear.
Dire team pick. Oh, we're going to have ourselves a very interesting game. Hellraisers with the Brawlers, the Balkan Bears, they've got Initiators, Controllers, some Nukers, but they've got a guy who just is a pain in the ass. It's the Terrorblade. Push power is strong. Team fight power is also quite good. Obviously, with the Sunder, you can just keep going. 10 seconds remaining. And also put someone in a very, very rough position.
5 seconds. Quite an interesting choice from HR picking up Slark after the Phoenix, though. Because if he gets those fire spirits onto Slark, he relies Radiant so heavily on getting, you know, right clicks off constantly during his ultimate.
Mm-hmm.
And Necro, yeah, I hear you clapping, Toby.
Well, how do you stop a Terrorblade from sundering? Scythe.
Works.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but you're not allowed to cast any abilities while you're under that scythe.
You would be correct.
Wonderful.
He's also not too bad against the illusions because of his death pulse. Reserve time. You can spam them out. Is this going to be Necro mid?
Yeah. I would say Necro mid, yeah. Dire I'd say Necro mid. I'd say Slark on the safe lane. And off laner yet to be known. But they banned the Earthshaker. I would laugh if this is actually the dual mid, the dual offlane I was talking about previously, but in this game it doesn't really work. The Wisp Ogre Magi, dual offlane.
Who's run that? Is that an HR thing?
That was a NIP thing. Radiant team
pick. The other Russians.
Yes. Oh yeah, Ukrainians. Ukrainians. There's more Ukrainians on that team than Russians. Yeah, but that was something they were doing. The Elder Titans is going to be the final ban out, so they're looking towards the offlaner. And also a potential team fight. This will probably be another support Phoenix. I'd be surprised if it's going to be a core. Unless what do they do? Actually, no. It could be a Phoenix mid. But up against a Necro, Phoenix versus Necro.
I've never seen that matchup, but Phoenix has a decent attack animation. Slows down Necros, who is already pretty slow to begin with. So he could outlast hit the Necro, definitely. Movement from the Skyrath Mage, they could kill him. I could see Phoenix working mid. But I'm still stuck on this Legion Commander. Where do they put her?
It's got to be offlane. Like, she just survives on the offlane. Potentially, they could go for a little bit more of an aggro kind of combo. Which I think is why maybe the Earthshaker could just be banned out. Because they want to let Legion Commander do a thing on top. Because you've always got press the attack, which will let you break free and run away with some good regeneration, but...
But that doesn't break you free of Slark's pounce.
Oh, that's true.
That's why I'm wondering if they keep the Phoenix up there, because he can just dive away.
Maybe Balkan Bears are wondering the same thing. They get a Witch Doctor. Okay, call the aggro tri lane right now. Wish Doctor, Legion, Skywrath, off. And then you run Terrorblade safe, Phoenix mid.
Potentially. You could also run the Witch Doctor, Skywrath at bot to begin with, and then roam them towards mid. Have the Legion mid, and then go for kills on the Necro early on. It's always risky leaving Terrorblade alone, though. When you've got heroes like Disruptor and Ogre who can TP or smoke and run towards that lane... that removes a little bit of the threat if that's a Doom offlane.
Well, I could almost actually let him change it up too. Actually, a Doom offlane, would that really work? Like Terror versus Doom? Because I'd feel like just a quick TP in from a Wish Doctor and a Skywrath would seal the fate of that Doom. I'd almost want to see Doom just sit in that mid lane, let Slark have the top with Disruptor and Ogre and put Necro on the offlane up against the Terror.
We'll see what they do, because Arteez is their mid player. He's played mid the last couple of games. But I don't know. Both teams have a pretty open draft. The only hero which you can sort of definitively say he is going there is Terrorblade going bot. He is the hero that's going safe lane. There's like no way you can deny that.
And then he heads towards the mid, and all of a sudden we all look like dicks.
I can see it happening.
Well, I can definitely guarantee you Hellraisers are going to be as aggressive as they can once they get their levels. For now, well, it wouldn't be a game of Dota without a pause. Because everyone loves to pause. Pausing is brilliant. Pausing is great. Lagging out before you actually connect in is even better. Or just not selecting your hero because you go AFK. It's been one of those nights, man. A night that tests the patience of anybody.
I'm just glad my throat hasn't died. I had a throat infection Thursday. A chest infection from Thursday, and I recovered kinda yesterday. So I'm still like, I'm still talking. I feel good about this. My throat hasn't given up yet. I'm gonna wake up in the morning and think, why did I do that? Why have I done this to myself?
You're just soft, Zerka. You're just soft. That's what you are.
I've heard you cast when you have been literally dead. And you've gone for like 14 hours of casting. What is he doing?
Doing damage is what I was doing. I remember it. I remember that period of time. It took... Oh, story time's back again! but it took 2 months before my voice went back to normal. That was after casting for 1 week with really bad influenza. But I had no choice. There was
14 hour days. There was games got to be cast.
That was back when I think we're still running the defense. And I had to commentate it. There was no other choice. I think it was also around the same time, like, I came back from Malaysia, and I brought some horrible, horrible disease with me or something. I came back, and everyone was complaining because Epi was the only one who was doing the commentary at that time. And the defense ticket said 100 games cast by Toby. I was like, well, there's still 180 games in total that we were doing for that defense season. It's like, please stop complaining, everybody. But that didn't matter. People still wanted refunds on their tickets and other things. Which, by the way, if you guys don't know, you can actually do that with Valve. You can actually apply to have your ticket refunded if you're not happy with your purchase. Just in case you didn't know that one.
Wow. What is Legion wearing? Why is that so shiny?
Say shiny thing. I see, because she's sitting next to a golden phoenix.
No, but look at the art. I know she's wearing the arcana, but I didn't realize it did that.
Maybe that's the particle effects directly on the armor itself, and then the actual particle effects outside of that.
Maybe.
Yeah, that actually has to be a direct armor thing for that to happen. Because it's also on the flags. Like, the flags are also having the same reflective, like, move on it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
See, I've got that Arcana for Legion, but I never play her. It's kind of a waste of money. But, what the hell?
Which one is this one? Oh, I have that one. I have that one.
The dual burning Legion swords of the damned death and destruction. What's it called again? Blades of Voth'Domosh.
It looks cool. It's awesome. That's all I know. What I have. Yeah. All right.
I just offlane Doom.
I forgot some of these ones. Attacking Levi's ass. What the hell? Broodmother effigy. Someone who actually likes a broodmother. Well, at least the Queen of Pain one's nice from HR. My rock and roll queen. That's nice.
That's Where's fine. The Broodmother one? Where are you looking?
Bottom right of bottom south. Oh, yeah. All the way south on the radiant side.
Ah, I see it.
Well done, Durga. All right, let's look at our lanes. So, up on top lane, we have Ogre Magi as well as Disruptor. They'll be babysitting the Slark, so it will be a defensive lane from HR that puts Necro in towards the middle lane, and then off lane will, in fact, be the Doombringer, while off lane for BBC, it will be a Legion Commander in towards the mid as the Phoenix, and Durka doesn't have to look like a fool. That means Terrorblade will be down on the bottom lane, being babysat by the Sky Wrath Mage as well as Witch Doctor.
Yay, Terrorblade bot lane. What a surprise. But yeah, I agree with you. This Doom is not going to have a good time down here. And they don't even need to TP the supports in if they're sat down here initially, and then they can roam with... Do they have smoke on any of them? Yeah, there's smoke on the Skywrath. So they could quite easily go mid for a kill on the Necro. Oh, this invis room to start off with. It's so annoying when you're a mid player, and you think, okay, this lane is okay for me, it's going to be pretty even. And then a Bane or a Skywrath appears on your lane and starts spamming Enfeeble and Arcane Bolt. And then all of a sudden, all of your early last hits just go down the drain. Like, here we go, straight off the bat. There goes a bunch of your HP.
You see what he levels up straight away as well? He just goes for the Heartstopper, or like, it's not even Death Pulse. If he can't get close towards the wave, he can at least damage him when they do come in close, because that range of the Heartstopper aura is just huge. So at least he's got some level of influence in the lane. Speaking of influence, Haki might have himself a bit of a harder time up on top. Goddamn's just trying to drop his life points down. Like, it's the Lightning Storm versus Legion Commander's press the attack. How much damage versus how much regeneration? Doesn't help when Goddamn takes all the damage from the creep wave, however.
Does Thunderstrike get debuffed by press the attack? My initial...
Not even death takes it away, so I'm going to say no.
Yeah. That's true.
Yeah.
It's just a thundercloud that follows you around constantly.
Yeah.
It's like you're Winnie the Pooh.
It's more like a tracker than anything else. Doombringer's going to be lucky to survive on this bottom lane. Retreats back to the tier 1 tower. Scorched Earth is what's keeping him alive down here. But it also means it's a Doom that is incapable of running a Devour on the bottom lane. So there's no injection of money coming his way at all, apart from just continuous tick up.
Oh, that's really nasty.
Yeah, but he's hit level 2 now, so he can actually do the Devour. The other major problem is also he doesn't have a mana pool to really support using both if he wants to be a little bit more aggressive or having a bit more of a presence in the lane.
That's if he can get close enough to get a creep to devour.
Yeah, that's also a little bit more difficult when you're up against a Witch Doctor and a Skywrath Mage who are happy just to force you out every single time. How's that top lane looking? Legion, there's your leash. Press the attack, and now he's like, wait, I don't break free from this. He still regenerated up, which meant the amount of damage they were dishing out wasn't enough. He'd also just got the creep wave being denied up, because they got pulled over towards the side camp, and it's a little bit too far away for him to pick up the experience. And now Disruptor. He won't be able to reach him. Not for any kind of harassment, at least. But the Doom's starting to get more levels down the bottom lane, which gives him a chance to try and recover, at least.
I'm quite interested to see what the Phoenix builds, because it doesn't feel like a hero you go bottle on. You just want HP regen as much and as often as you can, and he's built two gauntlets indicating Urn early on. I wonder if he just goes for the regular Urn Tranquils like you do on an offlane, and then allow your Legion to go for the bottle. She's saving up gold. You gonna buy boots? Okay.
Well, you definitely will pick up some boots. Right now, yeah, I'd probably say Urn and Ring of Aquila. And just start to rotate with the rest of the team. Let the middle lane be taken up by someone else who might not be having a great time. Like, be it Skywrath, be it Witch Doctor, be it whoever. Bottom lane, Doombringer up. That malediction is not a healthy thing for him to be taking damage with. And now he's dead. This is first blood right there. The Doombringer will in fact die to the orb attack of the Skywrath Mage. Ogmajai came in to help out. When Terrorblade turns on Metamorphosis, you have to retreat. There is no other choice.
And the TP gets cancelled, so this ogre's alone for a short while. I think Dredd just has to go back to base. He's used a clarity, might throw out one stun and then run. I guess with the increased
HP regen on the ogre. He'll move for the 4-minute rune and actually not even pick it up because the Witch Doctor's already here. And that's the exact rune he wants. No! He's got denied. Deny the regen! Oh my lord. Oh, whoa. And he just tried to also go for a concussive shot, but he was out of range.
Errors were made.
And ogres get a free life. A free ticket to kill. And where's he? He's actually moving up towards the top lane now. But he does it right underneath the Radiant Observer ward. So no ogre is now missing from that bottom lane, which means Witch Doctor is just going to get right on the tail of that Doombringer.
That's a pretty good Midas timing from the Slark, though. 32 last hits. He's going to have a 5-minute Midas.
Just he rushed it, though, to do this.
Yeah.
But that's the reason, too, why we weren't seeing any kind of kill up on that top lane when he trapped the Legion Commander. There was no power from that Slark because he has no items.
It's not that big of a rush, though, because he did go stout shield still. Sometimes, if you want to go really fast Midas, you just go for tangos and, like, a couple of branches. But he'll have that now.
Top lane, that's a level 2 glimpse. They're going to drag him back if he tries to run himself away. The leash, well, didn't actually get on him. In fact, the Slark has to bounce himself away. And with Phoenix coming up, the Witch Doctor is actually the one to get the kill here from BBC. They go 2-0, the Disruptor, 10 life points. No Icarus dive available, and he'll deny himself up to the neutrals. The only real option he had available to himself.
I thought he was dead. He was burning to the ground. Those fire spirits do a lot of damage.
Get out of there, Doom. He at least managed to pick himself up an Alpha Wolf. He just devoured an Alpha Wolf. So he can have that aura and crit.
But that was such good timing from the Radiant supports TPing up there. The Legion put herself in a position where the Dire have to go on that. It's like, okay, well, this is a free kill. Let's do this, guys. Then suddenly the Icarus dive comes in, plus the Witch Doctor cask bouncing perfectly between Creep Wave and Slark to find that kill. Everything was just spot on for them. Mm-hmm. Oh, the Legion did go bottle. Went for Quelling Blade, which was an interesting choice. I'm not sure why. I guess last hitting under the tower when they push it in. But bottle is definitely the best option.
Yeah. There's no real point cutting a path to freedom with this hero. As long as they're going up against an Aegis Prophet. So you're right, the Quelling Blade must literally just be for last hits. Make the most out of it. Maybe he just doesn't like either the animation or the damage which comes out from the Legion. Got a big move by the Doombringer. Take the big one. He's sending three heroes down here. Just cancel the Clarity of the Witch Doctor. Remember, he's still got this Alpha Wolf aura and has four Tranquil Boots. So he'll feel fairly invincible down this bottom lane. Just be careful up against that Terror Blade. Because he's getting bigger and bigger. And they're not doing anything to really stop him either. As long as they can. Like, what are you going to do? Rotate. You basically take the defensive tri-lane off the top lane and put it down towards the bottom. That's the only way they'll come back. Leash now over from Leech Commander. Again, Phoenix coming back in close. Icarus dives up, looking for the body block and the slow, and he's going to get both of them right now into the ultimate. The damage is not enough to kill off the Slark. He's at 15 life points, but he's far enough away. And there is no victory kill coming their way. In fact, Dread, he has a stun. Obviously, there's no multicast, and he's still got that third ability point, which he has not used yet.
If only Legion was level 6 there, that would have been such amazing play. I kept clicking on the Legion like, please be level 6 now, please be level 6 now. The amount of opportunities to
get that
jewel off.
He's not going
to get
that, he's going to die. They're going to come for the stun. Glimpse? That's a level 2 glimpse, they could have dragged him all the way back up to here. And there just would have been stun, ignite, and kill them all. Doombringer on the bottom lane is also dead. There's no survival when he's taken that much damage with the initial malediction, but up on top lane, Disruptor, he'll burn out from the Phoenix. So at this point, it's a 2-0 on BBC. They are making very short work here of HR.
And that's pretty much the reason why they didn't go on the Legion there, because they didn't know where the Phoenix went. They don't have any vision on the top half of the map, pretty much. And if that Phoenix is there, it can turn around the fight so quickly. Even with the Phoenix coming back in when they were in a relatively safe position, still manages to find a kill.
TP in now from Doom towards that bottom lane. He wants some help. Disruptor Glimpse is still on cooldown, so he can't actually help with the drag back. But there's Doom on the Terrorblade. His Metamorphosis is about to wear out. Glimpse still 5 seconds away, and this Terrorblade can be dragged all the way back up again. They could potentially drag the Witch Doctor back, but they're going to go for the Terrorblade. Back up into the wall, ensure the kill, and in fact, put him on the sidelines for a minute with a haste on the Necro. He's going to go even deeper here, right underneath Levy. The Dead Pulse actually give him a double kill. The fact you took the Necro out of play 9 minutes in, and he can't live for 60 seconds? That's just cruel. Legion Commander will also just TP off this top lane. All the way back to base, and even down to the bottom lane to help out. They could go for a kill then because of that. Because it's only two heroes, and they know there's only two heroes on this bottom.
I think they've got to adjust the way that Necro ulti works. 30 seconds flat adjustment on your respawn time, regardless of the duration of the game. Pretty crazy. Because that just doubled the respawn timer of the TB.
Man. Solitude. He's a rising dread. Not as sure about that. The glimpse is still available. They're going to drag him back, put the wall up, and he actually caught out two heroes in here. They put up the Phoenix Ball. They have enough damage, not with the Mystic Flare. The Doom is forced to move back right now. So is Dredd on very low life. And it's like he wants to Icarus dive up! Dredd's still got enough for a stun, but they're gonna at least get the pick off on the disruptor.
But no more. Two heroes limp away with about 200 HP each. Slark is doing pretty well up here on his own. Had the Midas for quite a while, went for Treads as a second. What do you reckon now? Because we've seen a resurgence of Shadowblade in recent times over the Blink Dagger. Shadowblade was the item on Slark for a long, long time, and then people like PyCat started picking up Blink for quite a while. Showed that it was quite a lot stronger because it was cheaper, allowed you more options to escape and initiate with the pounce. And then Shadowblade came back because it allows you to do more things in the enemy jungle and also gives you the extra damage on that first hit.
Right now, man, I think no Slark can really build for the mid game. Like, if they're there, use your abilities to get the kills, but you have to build more for the late game. Like, you have to make sure you're going to get to that Abyssal Blade and that you can stay alive during the fights. It's just the meta change, really.
You need that Skadi sooner than later.
Yeah, basically, yes. Oh, duel. Doom. Well, okay. Goddamn's going to lose this one, but maybe. No duel victory, just managed to hold the Disruptor in position for a while. The Skywrath definitely trying to help that out. Doom is trying to wait for an extra kill over here on the Terrorblade. He'll need support, though. Unfortunately for him, he can't get it yet. Dredd's still farming up that bottom lane, finding as close as he can to his level 6. But there's no other teammate here. Courier's going to fly in the Yasha. And Doom can't catch up to it. Doesn't have a Blink Dagger. If he Dooms and has the Ogre get a good stun off... Actually, he kind of should wait for Ogre to hit that level 6. He just started the Doom animation, but didn't finish it. But once this Ogre hits level 6, potential multicast could be killing off this Terrorblade.
Artes on top lane takes so much damage from that Phoenix, though.
Yeah, but what's Phoenix going to do? He just backs up and then returns back into it with a good life. That's what he can do. He doesn't have enough damage with the Shadow Blade. Oh, he does! Well, that answers that question. I didn't think his attack speed was going to be fast enough for it.
The debuff just wore out. He had the Fire Spirits on him for his first sort of two hits, and then he got his attack speed back.
Well, solo kill over on the Phoenix. That's nice for a Slark who already just picked up, and it will be a Shadow Blade build. He's already got the amulet in his stash. So he's keeping a secret for now. Duel. You can see him instantly into a Dark Pact. He wants to break free of that Legion Commander the second he tries it. Now, silence, Mystic Flare, goddamn, moves up high enough to be able to evade at least the Mystic Flare kill. But the attack is what does seal his doom. There's Dredd moving down with Doom himself. Bounce up on the stun. They're far enough away now. They won't be affected for Dredd. He's got Maledict on him, and that means death of Ogre Magi. Triggers to the Witch Doctor pop. And it's 9-3 on the board. The momentum for the Radiant side is really getting out of hand.
Well, the Skywrath has the same net worth as the Legion Commander. Like, exactly the same. He has 1,000 more net worth than the Doom. The Pounce, nice dodge by Haki there.
Yeah.
I think he'll still die, though.
He should.
Dark Pact and Scythe.
There goes your Scythe. You need to hit him again. Oh, they got him in time. Well, actually, no, they didn't. I think that was his... Yeah, he didn't, because look at the death timer. It was only 32... It was only 31 seconds.
Yeah, the Scythe happened, and they got the Necro got the last hit just after.
Yeah. They could have potentially weighed that one out a little bit more, because he already used Press the attack.
There was the Witch Doctor that released the cast just afterwards. If they'd waited a bit longer, there's always the threat that he gets away. Mm. Like, just about gets away. There is a very early Rod of Atos on the Necro, though. I like that.
Who's that specifically for, though?
Anyone, if you're chasing the TB or the Legion Commander, they want to try and escape from teamfights to get into a more advantageous position to re-engage, or just to leave, to go and farm. When you look at all of BBC, they've got pretty immobile heroes, apart from the Phoenix, but they all rely very heavily on their positioning in teamfights. So before they get four staffs and things like that, Rod of Atos is going to be really great for the Necro. Sneaky, sneaky.
They're going to try and jump in from behind, and Necro is going to walk straight into them. Seal, Mystic Flare, the Paralyzing Cast killed him in there a little bit longer. And they use the Death Ward as well? Okay, that commitment's a lot higher than I thought it was going to be. She also flagged the fact that Doombringer has finished up a hand of Midas. It's back in his stash right now, and the Courier is also just taking us a while to jump around the map. But this momentum from BBC is not going to be stopped. The Slark is already TPing out. He knows something is wrong here. There's too many of them missing. I don't think they didn't have a ward here looking for it.
No, I think the main thing was he was out of mana and he had Shadowblade in his stash. I don't think it was entirely because he was scared. He just wanted to go to base to regen, to replenish and go back into a team fight. Go and find something now.
Well, the move saved his life. He would be dead right now if he didn't. Because if he went back to farm, this Observer Ward from the Radiant side would have scouted him out. And that'll be his death. Middle lane's now going to get forced out by HR. Now, Rod of Atos, they want to put it to work. The Disruptor's still not level 6, however, which is not the greatest thing in the world for him. There's also all five heroes coming in towards the middle lane for BBC. This is not where they want to fight. The Doom, though, goes over from the Witch Doctor. We just have an Alderman. In comes that Icarus dive into the Alderman, too. And, well, he's just holding it. And there's no way for HR to dive under. In fact, they're going to lose multiple heroes. The Necro and the Slark. Attempting with the Urn Charge. He didn't get the Sprite off correctly. But now the Sunray going into Dread. He's slowly burning down. You cannot battle the Sun. And the Doom is just not willing to be part of this at all. They're going to take the mid tier 1 tower now. It's a perfect fight for BBC.
Yeah, it's a little bit questionable from HR to go in there. Sure enough, the Slark has the Shadow Blade and you want to try and find a pick off. But when you don't know where any BBC are and you know that they've got something like
Doom
a
is dead.
Oh, Doom.
Doom is dead. All they gotta do is just seal, orb, attack, form, done, Terrorblade. The remainder of his metamorphosis, and that's practically his Manda style.
16 minutes into the game.
Look at Slark. He's coming for the kill. He really wants a solo kill if he can get it. It's so much experience if he can. Leeches him up. He's still got his Shadow Dance available if he needs it. And that's exactly what he does do. But Legion Commander will come in. Well, press the attack. A little bit late. Could have done it the second she did finish TPing in. But Witch Doctor Ultimate. That's not enough damage to kill off Necro. Even
wait,
with the Malediction.
Glimpse.
They're dragging back the Witch Doctor. Now they might have enough damage on that Necro. No, the ulti too early from him. And then Paralyzing Cask bouncing up. Urn Charge plus the Pulse. He's bottling up as quick as he possibly can. Mystic Flare. The Urn Charge is now almost taking him out. That is 77 life points. The Slark will now enjoy the engagement. Ends up being a 3-for-1 at the end of the day. And yeah,
how did the Necro not die?
I don't know how he didn't die because they were also double stacking the urns. I don't know if you noticed, that's why I just bring up the menu instantly after. You've got an urn over on Phoenix as well as Witch Doctor, and they both put it over on the Necro. And the pure damage stacks from the urns. Multiple Necro, Terrorblades. But easy to isolate him once he's glimpsed back a long way. Funny enough, Terrorblade just thanked him for it. He took out the tower before death, which still makes that worth it for him. And now Phoenix on the bottom lane too. Chasing after Dreb. There's a stun. Or a disable at least coming out from the Yule Scepter. So Dreb will now die here, and that's going to be another 2 Urn Charges coming into the Phoenix. Or 1.
That's such a strong build. I really like that Yules. Because there's something you don't expect from a Phoenix, and that is a lockdown. That is a disable. You think, okay, he's expended all of his spells. I'm going to TP out now, and I'm going to burn in base for a little bit. And then the Yules comes out, and all of a sudden, his spells are back off cooldown. He's burning you again. That Ogre didn't know what hit him. This Ogre, not Ogre, this Doom Midas, though, it has given BBC an extra bit of room to breathe. Because, you know, initially they had that really good early game and they started picking up speed with the Terrorblade, getting the early Yasha, taking down towers, taking team fights, and then you got the Shadowblade on Slark after the Midas, which then gave HR some pretty good teamfight engagements. But the Doom Midas then gave time for the Legion to get Blink, the Skywrath to get some pretty good gold up in his pockets, the Witch Doctor to get Urn, Tranquils, keep the map completely warded. I'm just not sure what he builds into next. Actually, he's picked up a dagger, hasn't he?
Yeah. Yep. The idea from the Doombringer was a semi-recovery Midas, and it's a semi-prepare for the late game Midas. Because you know in the later portion of the game, you probably still have more confidence if the Doombringer is on the same level as the Necro, and then Slark is feeling confident enough that he can just run around starting hunting people. You've got Disruptor as well as Ogre. These heroes, if Disruptor can pick up an Aghanim, except that he keeps his usefulness, then the early stages, that's what he's meant to be doing. Whoops, why did I pick away from that one? Slark will die up on the top lane. Successful duel to the Legion Commander. But I'm just feeling like right now HR might think their late game potential is a lot better. I also just saw a Rod of Atos being used to drag the creep wave back. Attempted to Nar gonna fail now from Goddamn. It's not something you really think about with a Rod of Atos as a pulling ability.
Get over here. That's all I ever think of when I hear pulling Scorpion from Mortal Kombat.
I'm surprised, though, that actually works. Because you don't do any damage. Is under
attack. I think it kind of works like Ensnare. It does... It counts as damage, but it doesn't at the same time.
But Ensnare wouldn't actually drag aggro if you used it, right? Stun on bottom lane. There's no multicast for the ball, and ulti is up. And Phoenix just goes right over the top of it and back in again to that ultimate protection for him. So he'll hit the deck, and HR's gank has now failed. They did not cast that Doom. So the commitment wasn't high, and no multicast at all for Dredd.
The RNG is not with him.
No, it is not. Now Phoenix comes back in towards the middle lane, dives up, spirits up a little bit, drags the creep wave down, and Legion Commander will arrive with that Blink Dagger. Duel is off cooldown, so if Haki wants to try and jump for anybody, he can do it. While Slark, I don't know if he's hunting a courier, either way, he's running around with Shadow Blade, Invis, which is going to break the smoke if he gets any closer. Alright, there's your duel. So everyone, Dredd, gonna bring down Ogre Magi. A little bit further up, Necro, Silence, so we can't really help out. But on the bottom lane, the Wish Doctor's gonna go down to both Disruptor as well as the fully committed Doom. And Slark's on another run, and he found one. He found the Phoenix with no ultimate, just a Yule Scepter. And Fierce will just Yule Zao this one. Or dive away from that one.
And then fire over the cliff.
Hero has so many things which can be exploited. So many things.
But he's not a hero that does one thing well. It's true. It's why a lot of heroes nowadays don't really get picked, is that they're decent at a lot of things, they're pretty good at counter pushing, they're decent at taking towers, they're okay in team fights, but they don't do any of those things really well. Like, we always talk about heroes like Ogre and Jakiro. They have defined roles where they excel, but they also can fulfill other roles which they do okay in. Dual top lane.
Yep, it's over on Slark. Very quick, very easy. And another winner comes the way of BBC. 19-9 on the board. And they're looking good to take a one game advantage, even Witch Doctor. Alright, that was optimistic at best. Mystic Flare, though, they're still going to get the kill.
The bounces are real.
No, he tried to use the Death Ward. I don't know why he tried to use the Death Ward before the stun was really committed. Either way, it's two heroes down for HR. The tier 2 tower on the top lane gets mopped up by Terrorblade, and then a Yule Scepter up. Okay, there's no follow-up to that apart from a Sunray, but they get a better follow-up if they get any kind of detection here. No Sentry Wars being used. Goddamn, with the Invis Rune just walks directly through the BBC lineup. And Doom is up. He could jump the Legion, in fact. He really should be jumping the Legion Commander right now. The Invis will wear off in 3 seconds. And then the Disruptor is going to be very visible. And now Glimpse, Dragon back, press the attack. The Doom will be channeled, but you got Terrorblade still in the neighborhood. He could technically Thunder to save his own teammate, but that's not going to happen right now. Goddamn, getting nuked down by the Skywrath Mage. And they just fight it out. Necro ulti will execute the Witch Doctor. As now, Phoenix back into the world of the living, out of his little cocoon. And two heroes lost on either side.
And to the answer to the question which I asked at the very start of the game, press the attack does dispel Thunderstrike. I hadn't actually looked out for it since I asked it.
There was a question which I actually never got answered as well with the previous cast with me and Cap. And we asked, does Spectre's Illusions gain the advantage from Troll Warlord's ulti?
No. I know.
See, you say no, but do you know no?
Well, Lone Druid's Bear, Spirit Bear, used to get Troll ulti, but they changed it because he was a non-hero unit, and Illusions are also non-hero units, so I'd say no, 90% sure no.
Because it was one of those things where Cap was trying to, like, theorycraft and work out how Spectre can really come back into the meta again. Slark, they really need a gem. They really, really need a gem. I'll take
that. Because imagine Troll ulti with Terrorblade when he's got 6 illusions up. Towers would just cease to exist within matters of seconds.
Uh-huh. What the hell? Why did Dredd walk away from the duel? I didn't think that duel was over right then. But that Disruptor ulti is doing a lot of work. You are
dead. I didn't see it, but I'm guessing that the duel happened and Legion got glimpsed, and then Dredd had to go and chase the Legion.
Actually, yeah, that's probably exactly what happened. No, Glimpse is off cooldown. Oh, it's only 20 seconds. Yeah, yeah, it could have happened and then come off. Yeah, it's 20 seconds at level 4.
I can't really think of anything else. There's no unless Skyrath Forstaff Dread or something like that.
I can watch it. I can watch it in a minute. Everything was before my eyes, but the weird ass Dota I've seen tonight is just
never know what's going on.
It's making it difficult for me tonight.
Terrorblade has Skadi completed, pretty much just waiting on the Orb of Venom,
and he's got that too. Ba-womp, and she comes. Terrorblade is a beast. 25 minutes in, 1900 life points, 26 armor, and he's got the end of a haste room, which he's now going to use to run back to his own tier 1 tower right before the Slark will arrive, and just sends an illusion up. But because the smoke isn't breaking, they know it's an illusion, so they're not going to jump on it. Patience and control.
I've been really impressed at how well this Skyrath has done farming. He has 7,000 net worth. He just afforded a Ghost Scepter. I mean, that is so important up against heroes like Slark.
That's the only way to really protect yourself. There's Ghost Scepter as well to hold on through the duration of the leash, and then you could Forstaff yourself away to safety.
Oh, and Witch Doctor picked up a gem.
Yep.
Perfect life.
They had to. Like, there was no choice. They've missed a kill on a Slark like 4 times now because they didn't have vision, and they knew it too because Slark was still running around them.
So that's Skadi on the TB, Ghost Scepter on the Skara, so he can't get picked off by Slark coming in from the back end of play, and a gem on the Witch Doctor.
I like how I'm now the one getting the facepalm. Because the messenger is killed.
Why? What did you say? I can't remember.
It was the troll ulti on Spectre's Illusions. I'll dig that.
Ah, right.
On the haunt. It just caught up. So I'm getting the Toby face palms from the Twitch chat. Love you too, boys! Love ya. Send the love. Top lane just being forced out by Slark now. He's getting closer towards his own Skadi, but he's going directly into the Skadi after that Shadow Blade. Either that or he's hoping for a Lincoln Sphere, but he's not going up against a Doombringer, so I doubt it. Unless he's more worried about the Legion Commander jumping and dueling him. Again, no, I also doubt it.
There's no way you go Lincolns this game.
Yeah, it makes no sense. Look at Necro. He's got some really good farm on him. Rod of Atos, Blink Dagger, Radiant's having a Mystic Staff building into that attack. Scythe of Ice. Then again, considering how early that Rod of Atos came out, he's kind of fallen behind a little bit as far as his momentum goes.
And yeah, definitely.
Both him and Slark are still 6,000 net worth behind that of the Terrorblade.
Necro managed to pick up that blink, 7 minutes or something after the Rod of Atos, which was pretty good timing, but they've never been able to put it to use. They've always been on the back foot against this Terrorblade, just running them rampant.
Well, how do you get on the front foot? He's always split pushing you.
Yeah, exactly. There's very little they can do. And when you go a naked Mystic Staff, you know you're in a really desperate situation. Because usually when you're going for a Hex, and I'm guessing he's going Hex here, Shiva's is a possibility to try and clear creep waves, and it's decent armor up against the Legion and TB. But I think they need just one extra bit of lockdown. Just Hex someone. And when you're going for Mystic Staff as your first item there, you're not saving up for your big components. It's really risky, because if he dies, that's buyback gone, and that's a really important hero out of the team point.
They got all the lockdown they're searching for. They just picked up an Aghanim Scepter over on this Doombringer. It's going to force whoever gets hit to run away, and I'm actually wondering if they got enough life points to even survive that Doom. Like, it's only level 2 right now, so it's not as bad. When you add that plus 20 per second onto a what could be lasting forever duration Doom.
That's the main strength, is that if Doom stays alive and keeps that ticking over, it just depends on who he throws it on, though. And I think BBC, their main focus, if someone gets Doomed, is going to be to kill Doom. Because if they don't, he's going to be running around in teamfights, just trying to juke it out, keep the Doom ticking over on whoever he throws it on. Mm-hmm. And if you put it on someone like a Phoenix, even the Skyrath Mage or the Witch Doctor are pretty good targets, then that throws BBC's teamfight completely out of the window, because you can't rely on Terrorblade to win teamfights for you.
Yeah. And that Necro, though. Don't let him win team fights, but let him prep it up pretty nicely. Send 3 illusions down, take half the life points off Necro, a quarter of the life points off Ogre.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Necro went for the Shiva's.
It was the Shiva's guard?
Yeah, I think it was like a 60-40 decision. Like, I feel like it's my opinion that Hex would be better here, but
agreed.
Shiva's isn't a bad option because it helps clear it up against the TB illusions, decreases attack speed, slows them down.
But the problem is now Terrorblade has a full BKB, so I don't think he really cares about much. I'm hearing a duel going off right now. God damn, not looking too healthy. The Necro ulti will kill off the Legion Commander. The Phoenix ulti is down, but they're not doing enough damage in time, and Dread locked in. Same with Gorok, and they're both forced to stand here. Malediction, easiest of his life right there for Levi. And that'll be a double kill coming the way of the Skywrath Mage. Now in comes that Slark. He's trying to kill off that Phoenix. The Doom is not going to wear off. Actually, it is going to wear off before he should die. It's like forced away. Terrorblade will blink himself away to safety. And Phoenix is trying to keep up with the rest of his team. Yep, there she goes.
And then the five Terrorblades just walk up the ramp and say bye to that tier 3 tower.
Yep. Horrendous fight. Absolutely horrendous fight for HR. But they were already so far behind that at this point of the game, I think it would have been a real good task if they did get a team fight directly. Like, if it was just a couple of pickoffs, then yeah, they've definitely got a lot of strength there. But a 5v5 team fight up against such lamps like BBC has, it's difficult. And now even Sunder's over onto the Necrolite. They bring down the melee Rax. Is there a dive? The sun is just burning him down! With the urn charge as well. Your Icarus dive out, but welcome back again. Yule Scepter up, but sorry, man. You're still forced to remain here, and the Necro ult is going to put you on the sidelines for almost 100 seconds. Slark on the chase. He's after Terrorblade at the moment. There's three heroes there for him to choose from, but he actually stopped to attack into one of the illusions instead. The Roshan never died. So all of that was used. They did take the melee racks in the bottom, but they never killed Roshan before they moved up.
Oh, when Weehaw was dropping low there, I was thinking to myself, I really hope they kept a timer on that Necro ulti. It was like 10 seconds coming off cooldown. Nearly there. Weehaw turns around, uses his Sunder on the Necro, and then it just didn't matter. Can HR do this?
Yeah.
Looks like they can. There's going to be no contest.
There's nothing to stop them. There really is nothing to stop them. Without the Phoenix, they kind of feel like the chaos factor in the fights just goes out the window. Like, if they had the ultimate up on the Witch Doctor with the Aghanim's upgrade, then maybe they might feel a little bit more confident about it. Because then they could cause like a chaos fight around this little area just outside the pit. Now right now I think all they want to do is get the next level of farm up on the Terrorblade. Be it Assault Cuirass, be it whatever. In fact, actually, what does he look at next?
Radiance middle Butterfly.
Well, Butterfly is an option, especially considering there's no Scythe of Vice over on HR. But going up against a Doombringer is a better to actually have more life points right now. Radiance middle tower is under attack. Like, would it be better to try and get into that heart? Or are you already happy with 2.2k?
This is like one of the age-old questions with illusion-based carries. Because with Terrorblade, one of the oldest builds was you'd go Lifesteal crit on Terrorblade. And you just have these illusions that deal massive damage and lifesteal, and you can't do anything against it. And slowly over the years, we've seen illusion-based carries like PL, Naga, TB, just build stats over and over again. Just build stats, get your illusions as tanky and damaging as possible. And I think that's what he goes for here. Heart or Butterfly are pretty good options either way. Butterfly means that you're not really going to die to this Slark because he's nowhere near getting MKB. And
yeah,
like you said earlier, he wants that Abyssal.
Well, right now it's only a question of which one does he want first. Because he's still farming so quickly that he can take everything. Now, these illusions, it's the fact that the illusions do so much damage, he's capable of freely farming with them. He's sitting at 3.2k right now. I'm not going to say he should sell his TP scroll, but he could be picking up a Reaver before he tries to fight this.
You could even consider going a second Skadi.
You could. On agility-based heroes, though, I remember Honey's worst balance through my head on that one. He's always just like, the best agility stack item is actually a Butterfly. Because that's... I remember in one game I was trying to question, like, why would you buy two Butterflies? And he's just like, it's just a better item than any other thing you can pick up for agility carries.
Yeah. And they actually buffed Butterfly quite a lot. Now it has the Flutter, but also the evasion stacks diminishingly. So Butterflies do actually stack with the evasion.
This is really problematic for HR right now. They're four men smoking and one man shadowblading to try and find a kill, while their bottom lane is getting just pushed. Like, That's the reason why Necro had to come in here in time. He actually got his timing wrong with the Shiva's card effect, so it didn't actually have the effect on the creep wave after he arrived.
They're just chasing ghosts, though. Running through their own jungle to try and find one possible kill. Meanwhile, letting Terrorblade push top and mid with illusions and bot lane creeps just walking in there.
Mm-hmm.
And then you look in the Radiant jungle, farming efficiently, finding as much gold as they possibly can, building up these items over and over again. Witch Doctor nearly has Aghanims.
Nearly.
He's 300 off.
That's not too shabby. As long as that damn bird stops taking all the last hits, we're all good to go. It's like, yeah, just let me have it. Let me have it. Even given with the cask. Still short by 100.
Just go and sit in base now for about, 50 seconds.
Just don't die. Don't get picked off by the Slark. That should be like on his walk back to base, he'll get picked off by the Slark. Nice room for a Legion Commander to have. She's actually got some really good damage. It's one thing I always like about a Legion Commander. Like, the net worth is very deceiving with her. Like, I'd like to put her abilities as a net worth. Like, how much damage you get with the bonus. Like, you just, you got plus 52 damage. If you just want to buy that raw right now, you're basically looking at 3.2k, so just shy of the full relic. So technically, by duels won, she's got 3,200 gold worth of items on her. If I get my percentages right. And she's looking for another one. That disruptor would be dead if she just jumped straight away. The Radiant Observer wards up, and then realizing, wait, Necro is still in the neighborhood.
Everyone is here defending the bot racks.
Yep. What the hell is Phoenix? Oh, he's scouting for he's scouting for wards.
With that gem of his.
And now look for a target up on top. Slark instantly to Shadowblade and away. He's still got the Aegis Immortal, and we're turning ourselves into a 4-1 game now. Blinks into the tree lines, Legion Commander, but they've got observer wards inside the base and on the bottom. On the hill.
Slark?
Yeah. Why is he in that deep? Maybe the Aegis is gonna time out. Like, what's the? Yeah, it was literally like 10 seconds away from timing out. So we just ran in to see if he can find a kill. But there's still a lot of heroes up for HR up on the top lane. And Necro has to again come back down to the bottom lane to defend it.
That Legion is such a thorn in their side.
Well, there's not much you can really do about her. Like, you want to go down there and gank her? You can't. Okay, they just scouted her. The creep wave in the middle, she walked past it. So the no Legion's moved up towards the top, and she's about to hit. Okay, in 8 experience points. She's looking for the camp that's here to get it. It's like, nope. Nope.
Terrorblade, please.
Terrorblade's too fast. Just walk up and pick up your 8 points. Like, just be next to one creep. That's all you need.
Terrorblade is pinging the top lane. The creep wave is actually there. 3 creeps just died. You could have been there taking the experience.
She got a mud golem to get a level 16. One of the most useless creeps in the world gives her level 3 ultimate. So now an extra 0.75 duration on that ultimate of hers. The dual time. That really helps at all. But the bottom lane is just forcing out. He's got Slark down here. He's got TP back. He's almost finished his Monkey King bar as well, which should be flagged. While BBC, the vented through the top. The glimpse back, Legion, just breaks free of the wall. So it's a non-factor right now. Terrorblade's only a fresh metamorphosis, so he wants to make more of himself. And he can do it now, as well as mana style. But he needs the creep wave to also enter.
That's a really nice dire ward.
Oh, look at him try and dodge. Arkham Azhai down to 1/3 of his life points. The BKB from Terrorblade will go, as well as from Doombringer. He got the ulti off over on Terrorblade, but he got his BKB off in time. He has to sit back for the moment, while Legion Commander, Skywrath Mage, and soon to be Witch Doctor also die. The Alderman from Phoenix will buy him a little bit more space here. And then maybe Phoenix, yeah, you can't get out of that one. He's got Dive available, and kinda has to use it right now. He's, okay. He delayed himself before using it. I think he wanted to make sure he can get up on top of the cliffside. 4 heroes down for BBC. The bottom lane's pushed out far enough. There's no collateral damage. And the Terrorblade was the only one to escape.
I really, really like this Dire Ward. It's odd, but it gives them so much vision that they wouldn't normally have. Because they could see pretty much all of BBC getting ready to fight, whereas they'd normally only be able to see to, like, here. So they could see these heroes sort of standing in this area where BBC think, okay, it's nighttime, we're in the shadows, there's no way they can see us. We can initiate whenever they want, whenever we want, or counter-initiate whenever we want. So they send Terrorblade up here and think, okay, we've got Legion Commander and Phoenix and Skyrath all sitting in the back end, just waiting to pounce. Mm-hmm. But that wasn't the case, because HR knew what was happening. They put themselves in a perfect position to put down Static Storm, Kinetic Field, and have their heroes ready to react.
Well, they reacted perfectly, and they're claiming a big reward for it as well. The mid-tier 2 tower and the top-tier 2 tower. And they should be able to take both of them. Legion jumping in. Gotta be careful with that. They're just going to deny up the mid-tower now. But the top-tier 2 tower is killed properly by the Dire side, even though last hit was missed. But HR could look towards Roshan in a moment. He spawns up in 5 seconds. So, welcome back to the world of the living, Roshan. And if they're quick enough to scout it out, they can get in and out before BBC can do anything about it. Because there's a lot of damage over on that Slark now. It's actually nicer when he's fighting next to the Doombringer, who's giving in the parkour for her.
Is that the same wolf he's had since, what, 5 minutes into the game?
I believe so.
I don't think
I haven't seen him with another aura. Which is kind of funny, considering his Aghanim's upgrade. You'd think he might even consider getting a speed aura. Because he doesn't have a speed item, but there's no drums being built on this Doombringer. So I don't actually see him keeping up with the fight. Oh, trouble. Trouble. Four staff up, could do the work right now against Dredd. And Dredd is going to TP himself out. Yule Scepter will cancel it. He could just seal up Mystic Flare as well. Everything he wants. Dredd walked back into the Mystic Flare and then gets burnt by the sun. However, it will be Terrorblade who takes the kill. And they're pinging out going for the tier 3 tower in the mid. Okay. Well, that's probably the only creep wave which they can that's with them right now.
I love plays like that from Solitude. When Dredd's running this direction, you expect the Mystic Flare to be placed here. So Dredd did, you know, the right move, which is to run backwards, but Solitude placed it there, predicting where Dredd would go. Just the little things.
Well, he'll need that little thing again in a moment. They're coming up towards the high ground. Mystic Flare is off cooldown. Every single ulti for BBC is up, and the duel will already begin. Same with the Death Ward. Yule Scepter now going over towards the Disruptor, so he's taken out this fight as well. The buyback double came out with Ogre and Necro into that fight, and then maybe it's enough damage. Doombringer dropping low. The Phoenix Ball coming down to hit the Earth again. Will be able to connect the Terrorblade Illusions, ripping through the Doombringer, and the power from BBC is now real. Doom will buyback as well. There's three buybacks now coming out from the Dire side, while Phoenix multicast times it by 4. He's trying to swipe himself away, but the Igniter Yule Scepter's up. He'll evade the burn damage, which means he'll survive. The Terrorblade will not be so lucky, and Wishdoctor's trying to retreat. The Bouncing Castle giving him the space to almost do so. And he's going to drop the gem. He's going to try and hide the gem if he possibly can. There's no way out. It's a double kill now coming the way of the Slark. But that fight cost them dearly.
Phoenix never got a chance to use Pipe. Or did he use it at the very start of the fight? Then does it get refreshed by his Supernova? This is another hero that I rarely see. I know it refreshes his skills. Does it refresh items?
I can't give you an answer, man.
I'm pretty sure it just refreshes ability. So yeah, he never used Pipe.
Yep, he only used Urn, Yule Scepter, and a TP scroll, according to my teamfight recap. No Pipe appears. I have the full one up as well, so...
And then Witch Doctor ulti was pretty much cut short. Everything going wrong for BBC in these team fights. They're trying to push high ground all as one unit up against Static Storm and then the Necro.
See, I don't know if the Wishdoctor ult of them was even really cut short. Like, he threw it down because he knew he wanted the one kill. The problem was no one from HR was near it. So it was kind of ineffective. It helped kill off one hero, but it wasn't that team fight chaos you're looking to create with both him as well as Phoenix. Desolator's now up for the Legion. Increase the damage. Enjoy the negative armor. And she's already got bonus 70 damage from her duels. Still feel like BBC, like, for all the team fights they keep losing, I still think they have this. They're 12,000 experience behind, but all they really have to do is just claim the top racks. I make it sound so easy.
But yeah, I think they should go back to what they were doing 10 minutes ago. Have the Legion Commander sitting here, blinking into the trees when it's a little bit dangerous, and pushing this lane in. Because when you see BBC make moves like this, where they sweep into the jungle, try and find a kill, these lanes are both pushed out by HR. So the only way they can actually get into the base is up through mid, which is not the best position to be in.
Well, I found a target. What is goddamn doing? He is so far out, they're going to see him. And then they're trying to use him as bait. The rest of HR is just walking down the mid. They initiate in on goddamn, and he will actually drop from this. The fire is burning him from the Phoenix into the ultimate. Phoenix is not going to survive through this, but the Witch Doctor Ultimate is shredding them apart. The stun will finally get in there. But it took a little bit too long. It was the mini bash coming out from the Monkey King bar. Still a double kill for the Slark. The duel is started up by the Legion Commander, but she's not strong enough to kill up the Necro, who is just stuck in the tree line. A missed blink and still an Aegis to the Immortal. I take it back. I have jinxed BBC so hard right now. HR are going to force down mid and get themselves a counter Rax.
So unfortunate for the Legion, though. She blinked in here onto the Slark, and Slark hits his ultimate button. Goes in Viz and you can't ulti him. No more duel. If they manage to get that duel off, I think that fight goes completely the opposite way.
Mm-hmm.
So you remove Slark from the team fight. Terrorblade then can just turn around and fight. He doesn't care too much about anyone else. Sure, he's doomed. But so what?
Slark's just burning in the fires. He doesn't care. Back into Invis with a Shadowblade. Waiting for the right opportunity to pounce, and now it comes as well. The damage on the Sky Wrath Mage, 100 seconds on the sideline. That's because he bought back right then to add on all the extra time. The bottom lane has pushed in all the way. It's taking out the range racks, but they pounce it even deeper. Phoenix will drop, and Slark now, he's on the sideline for 90 seconds. I don't want to say this game is over, but I feel like this game is over. Look at the money on Slark. This guy is loaded.
Not just that, but you look at the heroes respawning now for BBC.
That's too long.
Terrorblade is alive.